Dear students, this is your English teacher, Garima Ma'am. Today, we are going to learn chapter number 1 of class 3rd, poem, Never Give Pain. Children, you all must be knowing the meaning of pain. It means giving trouble to someone or hurting someone. So children, tell me, do you love birds and animals? Yes, of course. We all love birds and animals. Do you throw stones and hit them? Definitely no. We should not throw stones and hit them. Birds and animals are so beautiful. When we look at them lovingly, they are the creation of God, as we all are. So we should never hit or tease them, but rather love them, as we all like to be loved. So children, this was a short summary of the entire poem. Now let us discuss the poem line by line. The first two lines. Little children, never give pain to things that feel and live. This means that, my dear little children, you all should never give pain to the things and creatures that feel and live. So what are the things that we feel and live? The things that feel and live are called living things. For example, plants, animals, birds, insects, etc. So we should never give pain to all these living creatures. I hope the first two lines are clear with you all. Now, the next two lines. Let the gentle sparrow come for the crumbs you save at home. Children, you all must be knowing what is a sparrow. A sparrow is a small brown colored bird which eats small insects, grains and bread. Children, do you all know the meaning of crumbs? Crumbs are the soft inner portion of the bread. These two lines means that let the gentle sparrow come to eat the crumbs which you have saved at home. Here, the sparrow will come to your house to eat the crumbs of bread which you have saved at your home. Now, the next two lines, as his bread you throw along, he will repay you with a song. Children, do you all know the meaning of repay? The word repay means paying back. Here, the poet wants to say that the bread which we throw along the sparrow will repay us with a song, means the food which we offer to the birds, they greet us back with a song. I hope, children, the first paragraph is clear to you all. Let us start the second paragraph. Next, the two lines are, never heard the timid hare peeping from her green grass lair. Children, what is the meaning of timid? The meaning of timid is shy. And what is the meaning of peeping? The meaning of peeping is to see from behind something. So let me explain these two lines. We should never hurt the animals. For example, the timid hare or the shy hare, which is peeping from her grass, green grass lair. Green grass lair means the small bushes and shrubs where the hares hide. Iska matlab hai, jahan pe khargosh chhipte hain. Now, the next two lines. Let her come and sport and play in the lawn at close of day. Children, do you all know the meaning of lawn? Lawn means an open space between the woods. घास का मैदान या घर के बाहर खेलने की जगह. Now let us discuss this line. Let the hare come and play spontaneously in the lawn till the evening. This means that the little hare come and play with us in the lawn till the evening. So children, hope the second paragraph is also clear to you. Let proceed towards the third paragraph. The two lines are the little bird so soaring high to the bright windows of the sky. Soaring means to fly, means unna. Let us discuss these two lines. The little two birds flying very high to the bright windows of the sky. This means that the small little birds are flying to search great heights so as to touch the windows of the sky. इसका मतलब है चिड़िया आसमान में इतनी ऊंचाइयों में उड़ रही है कि हमें ऐसा लगता है कि वे आकाश की ऊंचाइयों को छू रही है. Now the next two lines singing as if it were always spring and fluttering on an untied wings. Spring means the pleasant spring season. या आप हिंदी में इसको बोल सकते हो वसंत ऋतु, जहां पेड़ों पर नई नई पत्तियां, फल और फूल खिल जाते हैं. Fluttering means to move back and forth rapidly. Means पंखों को फड़फड़ाना या लहराना. Now let us discuss the two lines. The birds are singing and dancing as if it is a spring for a long time, and they are rapidly moving their wings freely without any foundation, which means they are very happy. Now let us move to the last two lines. Oh, let them sing their happy song. Never do these gentle creatures wrong. It means let the birds sing their happy song, but don't do any wrong things with these innocent living creatures. Hope the whole poem is clear to you all. Thank you. Stay fit, stay healthy.